Mathematicians express relationships between quantities in many different ways, but three of the main ones are tables, graphs, and equations. In this video, we're going to go through examples of each of these to see how they work. A table is probably the most straightforward way to express a relationship between two quantities. It's just a straightforward listing of values of one quantity and the corresponding values of the other quantity. In the table we have here, we have two quantities called x and y. And on the top row, we have the values of x, and on the bottom row, we have the values of y that go along with them. For instance, looking here, we see that if x equals 3, then y equals 1. So based on that, we can make a statement like, if x equals 3, then y equals 1. We can also do this the other way around. Looking at this column right here, we can see that if y equals 1, then x equals negative 5. 1. A graph gives us a visual representation of a relationship between two quantities. In this case, the graph is this diagonal black line that's running through the center of the screen. By looking at points along this graph, we can identify corresponding values of x and y. For instance, if I look at this point right here, I see that its coordinates are negative 4 horizontally and positive 2 vertically. Negative 4 is a value in the x quantity, and positive 2 is a value in the y quantity. So what we can see is that if x equals negative 4, then y equals 2. On the other hand, if we pick another point, say this one, again, let's write the coordinates. We see that horizontally, our coordinate is 1. And vertically, our coordinate is negative 3. So from this point, we can say, if y is negative 3, then x equals 1. Notice that in each case, I had to pick a point that was on the black line. The black line is the graph. If we pick a point over here, it doesn't fit our relation because it does not lie on the graph. An equation gives us a symbolic representation of a relationship between two quantities. In this case, we have the equation y equals 3x minus 7, and this is telling us how values of y are related to values of x. If we want to know a specific pair, we can say pick a value of x, like say if x equals 2. We would like to know what value of y corresponds to x equals 2. Well, what we can do is take the 2 and put it in where the x goes, and then figure out what we get for y. Y equals 3 times 2 minus 7. Well, 3 times 2 is 6 minus 7, which is negative 1. So we conclude that if x equals 2, then y equals negative 1. We can do the same thing if we are given a value of y instead of a value of x. Suppose we want to know what value of x corresponds to y equals 5. We can say if y equals 5. And we're going to do the same thing that we did last time and plug that value into the equation. But in this case, this is a value of y that we're given, and so it needs to go in where we see the y in the equation. So what we can say is that 5 equals 3x minus 7. Now the bad news here is that we don't have our answer directly in front of us, but we can get it by doing a little bit of algebra. In this case, we would need to move the 7 over by adding 7 to both sides, and we end up with 12 equals 3x. Now to get the x by itself, we need to get rid of the 3, and we do that by dividing both sides by 3, and we conclude 4 equals x. In other words, if y equals 5, then x equals 4.